This is Dror Moshe Kasuto.
Shalom uvracha. We're explaining now the last day of creation, the seventh day, day of Shabbat. Vaychulo shamayim ve'aretz v'chol tzeva'am. The sky and earth and all their armies have been completed. Vaychal Elohim b'yom ha'shvi'i melachto asher asa. And God, the Creator, in the seventh day, He finished, completed doing everything He did. Vayishbot b'yom ha'shvi'i mikol melachto asher asa. And then He rest. He decided to rest from all the actions, from all the work. Vayivarech Elohim et yom ha'shvi'i vayikadesh oto. So the Creator blessed the seventh day and made it holy. Ki bo, because in that day, Shabbat mikol melachto asher bara Elohim la'asot. Because in that day, He rest, He finished from all His work that He created on earth. So, it's very important for us to understand about the Shabbat, about the seventh day, that we are talking about the seventh day. Now, myself, I don't know why in different religions they chose the first day of the week, Sunday, to be important, and I don't know why in different religions they chose the sixth day, Friday, to be the most important. I don't understand it. And the Bible is 100% clear. There is no doubts about it, no arguments about it, that the seventh day, that the day of Shabbat, that is the holy day. The day of Shabbat starts at Friday evening, and since that moment, holiness is coming down to the world, purity, and like it's a source of health, it's a source of relaxation, it's source of peace in the house, it's source for deep understandings. And if you don't rest in that day, you cannot connect yourself to the blessing that is hidden and treasured inside of that day. And if you want to imagine that if you'll rest on Sunday, it will be the same, it won't. If you think to yourself that if you'll rest on Friday, it will be the same, it won't. Maybe you will enjoy a weekend, like you're gonna enjoy a day off work. But the real deep meaning of Shabbat is treasured in Shabbat. So for that, every person should connect himself to God's will, that in the seventh day we are resting, we're relaxing, we're sitting with our families, we're eating together, we're enjoying together, we're trying to become spiritual together and deep together. And people can achieve the heights, people can achieve huge things, because really in Shabbat, things that are treasured are beyond our reach of understanding. It's such a humbling day, it's such a beautiful day, it's such a spiritual day, and the deep understandings that can come out to the world in that seventh day are so deep and so interesting and so amazing that it's really impossible to understand without practicing it, without really going into the depths of Shabbat and trying to keep it and to relax. And also to the religious people, Jewish religious people that are keeping Shabbat, also like you need to learn so much about Shabbat, because Shabbat is not like this crazy machine and system. Oh, right, we need to go and catch the class and to make it on time to the minyan and to the Bet Knesset and to do this and that. And like, oh, third meal we must catch and this and that. There is something quiet in Shabbat that is a result of the relaxation in Shabbat, and not the mess and not the balagan, the emotional pressure and the society pressure, community's pressure on the individual to participate and to come and to be and not to miss and not to lose and this and that, and like kids must go and this and that, like catching and completing and achieving and losing the blessing. What the Creator did. Creator relaxed. Vaychal Elohim b'yom ha'shvi'i melachto asher asa. He finished all His work. Vayishbot b'yom ha'shvi'i mikol melachto asher asa. And then He relaxed. He rest. And blessed that day. And made it holier. than the rest of the days, because in that day he rests. And it's very important that you'll do all the great things you want to do and to achieve out of deep calming and relaxing understanding of the beauty of that day. It's written that hopefully we'll make it to that part, that when the Creator commanded Am Israel, the holy nation of Israel, to keep Shabbat, so he told us, I have a treasured gift that I want to give you, and its name is Shabbat, and I'll teach you how to keep it, and I'll teach you what to do in it. It's a gift, it's a blessing. And if a person in his mind is still working and planning and like doing and like he doesn't relax, he cannot enjoy the blessing and the gift of the seventh day, the day of rest. Ele toldot hashamayim, those are the things that took place. That's exactly how the sky and earth been created. Behi bare'am. And if you will notice in the Hebrew Bible, it's written Behi bare'am. The word Behi bare'am is written with a small letter He. All the letters are written in one size, but the letter He, the second letter in the word, is written in a smaller font. Behi bare'am. And why is that? The meaning of the word Behi bare'am means when they have been created. So that's exactly how heaven and earth been created. Beyom asot Adonai Elohim eretz v'shamayim. In the day that the Creator, that God made earth and sky, this world and the world of beyond. So when the Creator created all those things, so they have been created. And when we're saying the word been created, have been created, behi bare'am, so the letter He, like we said, is written in a smaller way to teach us few things. I'll tell you two main things. One of them is that the meaning of the word Behi Bare'am is that the Creator created them with a small letter He. The letter He is parallel, I think you say in English, like equal to the letter H in English. It's just the way that you take out air from your mouth. You just like you say, it's like a breath of air. You don't say like, it's not a vowel, it's not bet or gimel, it's not like A or B that you pronounce it. Hey, it's only the air that floats, that comes out from your mouth. So for the Creator to create all the wide world with all of what it contains, all the details and like the how complex it is and like all the tiniest things and the great balance of all creation, all the sophistications and like all the how complex it is, all of that for him was just like expressing that small tiny letter Hey, like only a breath of a hair for a breath of air for him. My English is not perfect, and I hope you don't laugh at me. But it can be a nice joke to laugh once in a while, so it's okay. So this is one explanation why the letter Hey is written like that, to explain to us on the greatness of the Creator, that he is so great, so divine, that he was able to create all this magnificent and complex creation with a breath of air. And that's it. Second explanation is Behi Bare'am, is that the Creator created the world for Avraham. Behi Bare'am means for Avraham. By the merit of that righteous man, the pillar of earth, the man of faith, that soon we'll read and learn about him, that he was the one that revealed the Creator. He was the one that uncovered the true potential of our world to serve the Creator and to connect ourselves to him with a happy heart and a wishing soul based on grace and kindness and generosity and all good attributes. He was the one that for him the world has been created. We will continue the next time. Thank you so much. May the Creator bless us all together as one. Amen.
We hope you enjoyed this video very much. Please now remember to subscribe and like this video and share it with your friends to help spread faith in the world. For more, please visit emuna.com. May your light shine always, and your requests should be answered with the greatest blessings. Amen.